I'm Brad Paul. Welcome to the Acoustic Cafe. This is where we bring you the best in contemporary folk music. And I'd like to introduce my guest, Greg Brown. Hi, Greg.
Hi.
How are you doing?
I'm doing pretty good. How are you doing?
Glad you could drop by.
Oh, yeah.
And you've been vacationing a little bit up north of the border?
Well, yeah. It's turned out to be, it was a working vacation, which I do a lot in the summer, but it's turned out to be a little more work, a little less vacation than I would have liked.
Those busman's holidays quite often turn out that way.
Yeah, yeah, busman's holiday, yeah.
Right. You know, I wanted to say the last two records that you made for, actually the last three records you've made on the Red House label, I think have had some of the best production for a singer-songwriter that I've heard in a long time.
Wow, thank you, that's surprising. I mean, we do them real quick, you know.
Really?
And we don't have any producer.
You do it yourself?
Well, the musicians really do it. I mean, we just, we get together and run through the songs, and then we go tape them.
There's a lot that's going on the record, though. I mean, it might be something like panpipes or something that sounds like panpipes here.
Yeah. You know, one thing I've always done on my records, which I do in real life, too, is... when I make records, I play with people that I play with a lot.
So there are no
surprises.
David Moore,
Randy Sabine, all these different people I've jammed with in a lot of different groups over the years. So I mean, we have a good time playing together, and hopefully that shows.
I think it comes through on the records without a doubt.
Now, I don't know, what does a producer do anyway?
Well,
what does a record producer do? I suppose there's as many answers to that as there are producers.
Our producers have a lot of different roles that they take. Some have a lot of control, and some just sort of sit there and make sure the coffee's hot. And
there are famous producers, aren't they, who have like a, they're famous for getting a certain sound or something.
Well,
I'm glad you like the sound of them. Because,
well, there is. There's a very distinctive sound.
I do them quick, and I've always felt a little bad about that. You know, I don't really... I don't mind going into the studio, but to me it's just another gig. You know, and I admire the musicians who can say, well, I'm going to go in and do a record, and they're really painstaking about every little thing. They're trying to make the best record they can make, you know, and I maybe I'm just not patient enough or something, but...
That comes through in your songwriting, too, though. I mean...
But I'm not very patient.
No, that you don't... that you don't that you approach the songwriting from a very I'm going to just sit down and do this, and there's not a lot of
that's true,
you know, agonizing over at least that's the impression that I've got, that you have this incredible ability to whip out songs that are very right to the point. They say a lot in very little.
Well, I think I work on them inside as near as I can tell, you know. I don't I'm sure not very disciplined about it, you know. I mean, I don't really try to write songs, but they, every once in a while, just, you know, some pop out. And
that's an understatement.
Well, I think there's plenty of songs already, you know. I mean, if you think about all the songs that have already been written, and more being written every day, but what can you do? You know, if one comes along, I'm not going to turn it away.
Have you always done your own material? Or try
No, not really. I mean, still on a lot of nights, you know, I might do a Jimmy Rogers song, a Robert Johnson song, a Billie Holiday song, a Julie London song. I like to do a lot of other people's stuff. Yeah.
Now, I understand you're working on a new project that is a little bit different than the previous records.
Well, actually, I got two more of these records coming out. There's one coming out in August that I really wrote it about 2 years ago. I went to Europe, and I found it very relaxing over there. And I wrote a bunch of songs about how disgusting and awful it's getting in America. And, you know, just the stuff that's happening, kind of the 7-Elevenization of the nation. And I wrote these songs over there and came back and put a band together and taped them. And now they're finally going to come out. I'm sure it'll do a lot of good. You know, I'm sure it'll really help. And then after that, for some reason, I don't know, that album didn't come out right away. I think we just put out another one. And then I just, after that, I wrote a bunch more new songs. And we just taped those in the spring. Sean Colvin came out and sang. And my friend Bo Ramsey plays guitar on there. And that record was real enjoyable to do. So that one should come out, I don't know, This one's coming out in August, and I think maybe the other one will come out in February or something like that.
Yeah. So. Iowa comes up a lot in your songwriting.
It seems to. I've never really gotten it. You know, I mean, a lot of times when I play someplace, they'll say, "Here's Greg Brown from Iowa."
Mm-hmm.
Like it's some kind of an amazing thing, you know. I mean, they don't say, "Here's Dick Jones from Connecticut," you know, or "Here's Wanda Wilson from California." But something, maybe something about, is it that unusual to be from Iowa? Maybe the stuff, maybe
the songs, though.
Well, I think it's in the Iowa Waltz songs.
Yeah, yeah.
For sure, which are songs that I wrote in small towns in Iowa. But, and on the Goodnight Kiss album, I guess there's some Midwestern kind of stuff.
Yeah.
I don't
Mississippi
know.
Moon and the.
Yeah, about the boys
town,
by the river.
Our little town.
Yeah, the little town song. Yeah. I guess, you know, that's what I write about is.
Is that where you're from originally? Did you grow up in the?
Well, Iowa, Kansas, and Missouri. Mm-hmm. My dad was a preacher, so we moved. We moved about every 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah.
Spent a lot of time in the church. Was the gospel music of influence on your?
Yeah, gospel music. I don't know how big of a. When I listen to my songs, I don't hear a lot of gospel influence, but I love gospel music. If I'm sitting around jamming with my friends, always at the end of the night, you know, that's what we do. Is gospel music, sure.
Kick back and have a good time.
Oh, yeah. Mm-hmm.
Great.
Yeah.
Well, I think that's what we're looking forward to doing now.
Well, okay.
All right.
Well, it's interesting that we talked about that. I was sitting in the back room here waiting to play, and I wrote a song. So I'm going to try and do it for you. I don't know. I just wrote it about 5 minutes ago, so I don't really know it yet, but... Driving into the city, used to make me smile. I knew somewhere in there I'd find you. You're gone now, and I just think I'll get there after a while. And used to be my shining city. When you were around, used to be my shining city. Now it's just another town. Now it's just another town. The movies and the bookstores, and all that street life, you know. Used to grab me, make me happy walking with you. But now you're gone, and it's all lost its glow. And this used to be my shining city. When you were around, used to be my shining city. Now it's just another town. Now it's just another town. Ain't it somehow just one soul can put out so much light, fill you up and wake you up? Nothing else is that bright.
This used to be my shining city. When you were around, it used to be my shining city. Now it's just another town. Now it's just another town. Now it's just another town.
Well, thank you. Well, thank you very much. Thanks. Yeah, it's all right. We'll get a string arrangement with that. Get some of those thump thump drums, you know.
Used to be my shining city.
I can hear it now. Well, there's a little song. It seems to me like a lot of communication is really in the tone of voice. People can say really nasty things in a really sweet way, in a really sweet voice. So people can say really sweet things in a really mean way, you know, and later you get kind of confused. Anyway, if you've had that experience, this song's for you.
I've been up all night long. It felt right, now it feels wrong. I just don't want to feed my misery. The world news and some black coffee. I don't want to have a nice day. And I wish that you would not say that to me that way. I don't want to have a nice day. I think if somebody unscrewed my head, I know I look like an unmade bed. And you know when I feel this way, what it is what I say. I don't want to have a nice day. And I wish that you would not say that to me that way. I don't want to have a nice day. I can remember a little restaurant, you know, somewhere down around Chicago. She threw that whopper right in my face, and then she said, have a nice day. I said, I don't want to have a nice day. And I wish that you would not say that to me, not that way. I don't want to have a nice day. What do you want to do then? I want to weep. I want to sleep. I want to get by cheap. I want to creep into the deep. I want to fall down in a heap. I'm gonna do it right on your floor. If you say that to me just once more, you'll have to roll me right out the door. Yeah, and give me the old what for. I can remember what the people did back when I was a little kid. They didn't ask you to be always high. They just said thank you and goodbye. Have a nice day. And I wish that you would not say that to me that way. I don't want to have a nice day. No, 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 no.
Oh, thank you. Thanks a lot. I'll sing a little song. This is there's an old Chinese poem. I think it's an old Chinese poem that goes, I may live on past this time when I'm so unhappy and remember it fondly. Yeah, this is sort of the Western version of that. Oh, things may never be that good again.
A little creek you could spit across. Well, Jimmy and Mays took one more toss, so a spinner's bride in the evening air. People always said there ain't no fish in there. Well, grown-ups, they ain't always right, 'cause Jimmy and me walked home slow that night. Well, right down Main Street in our pier flyers with 2 5-pound bass making grown men liars. And Jimmy, if I had known, I might have stopped fishing right then. It's just as well we don't know when things will never be that good again. Hey, right on an autumn night, well, we was 15 if I remember right. We were far apart at the start of the ride, yeah, but somehow we ended up side by side. We hit a bump and she grabbed my arm, and the night was as cold as her lips were warm. And I shivered as her hand held mine, yeah, and then I kissed her one more time. If I had known, I might have stopped kissing right then. It's just as well we don't know when things will never be that good again. She was older than me, I guess. Summer was invented for her to wear that dress, so I knew about risk and she knew about proof. And that night she took me up on the roof, and we could see the lights of the little towns. We could watch the August stars come down, oh, the shooting stars and the meteorites. Yeah, we went on a ride through the sky that night, and oh, if I had known, it all over again. Some things just get better and better, better than they already been.
Oh yeah. Oh, thank you. There's a number that I wrote for my mother. I'd never had written a song for my mother. Written, it's kind of a, I suppose, you know, it's been done a lot. I'm sure there've been a lot of songs written for mothers. Some really awful, awful songs written for mothers, and I'm sure a lot of good songs too. But I never had written a song for my mother. I'd written songs for a lot of other women that I know, my grandmothers, my daughters. I'd never written a song with my mother, and she didn't complain about it or anything, you know. But when I'd go see her sometimes, here this last year, sometimes supper would just taste kind of funny, you know, and I... That's not true. I just felt like writing a song for her. She's had a pretty amazing life. She grew up kind of in the sticks, and... Actually went to school in a covered wagon, which I know sounds goofy. I mean, it wasn't that long ago. It was, I guess, in the 1930s, early 1940s, she would have been going to school. And there was no gravel on the roads. It was just red mud roads. And so she went to school in this wagon, which she's never forgotten. It sounds kind of romantic, but I guess the reality was quite different, as it often is. She always wanted to get to the city, you know, like a lot of country people, and she did. She made it to the city. She's a big-time realtor in the Twin Cities now, Minneapolis, St. Paul. Interesting life. Anyway, here's a song for her.
There's a girl standing on a red mud road, looking up at Lagos Hill. She has never been much farther than that, but she know someday she will. Hillbilly girl, big, big world. She is strumming on a catalog guitar, singing songs she's always known. She has her father's will and her mother's clear eyes and a wild heart all her own. Hillbilly girl, big, big world. She is wondering why red road goes as the stars come out above. Will she make it to the lights of the city bright? Will she find someone to love? Stands on that same old road with her father's hand in her own. And though mother is gone, still those clear eyes shine as bright as they've ever shone. She still can be strong. And yes, she made it to the lights of the city bright, but she never forgot where she is from.
Thank you. Thanks a lot. One more tune here, I guess, huh? Is that about what we got? I'll sing you a tale of love from southern Iowa, where I was born. I've been spending quite a bit of time down there with my grandpa, going down to see him. He's 88 now. I go down, he plays the banjo. I still go down and see him. We play music till I have to go to bed. Spending time down there where I was born. This is a story of love from down that way, I guess you could say.
I'm sorry I hit you. I'm sorry I wrecked your car. Sorry I met you that night at the Why Not Bar. But now I got you, and you got me for life. I will hand you this bottle, honey, if you will set down that knife. never leave you. I'll never go away. And even if I do, I reckon I won't stay. No, I'll never leave you. I'll never say. If I do, you better come back to me. I've had lots of women, some even fatter than you. Ah, but not a one of them could do all the things that you. I wanna marry you. I wanna see you in that gown. I wanna carry you to a room, take it all the way down. I'll never leave you. I'll never go. Even if I do, I reckon I won't stay. No, I'll never leave you. I'll never set you free. And even if I do, you better come back. Trailer from my uncle, any color you choose. Double wide furnished, one that's never been used. A little place in the country, just a ways out of town. Get home to you. I don't want nobody around. I'll never leave you. I'll never go away. And even if I do, I reckon
thank you very much.